As I didn't get time to during the other surgeries that we were doing, as you saw in the last one, which we're doing with the Drake, I couldn't monitor and film myself doing monitoring at the same time. So I'm just going to show you with this stuff dog what I would do if the patient was anaesthetized under the effects of isoflurane. So check his heart rate firstly, looking at the clock and having the leads for 15 seconds, sometimes it's about 40 at the heart rate. Then I would take its temperature, because we obviously have glue on it, and put that into the dock, as long as the vet wasn't working on an area down here, which will cause it to be contaminated. Check the temperature. And if it's a healthy dog, it should say about 38 degrees. Check its capillary refill time. That should be less than a second. Check its blink reflex. See where it's positive or negative. Which case it would be positive. Also check its vertical pulse. Again, pulses for 15 seconds to get the correct pulse, and then also watching the respiratory and the chest should be going up and down and down and down. So generally a dog should be between 12 and 20, so we're going watching her up and down, up and down, up and down for 15 seconds, and then times that by 4. Also just make sure if the patient was actually under anesthesia that you had the correct oxygen levels. We generally put them on 2, and the correct isoflurane, which we do from 1 to 2 depending on the patient. Yes, so we checked, and also the mucous membrane colour, so I want to make sure it's nice and pink, otherwise there's some sort of hidden problem which can affect the patient. So capillary refill time, checking like that, mucous membrane colour, pink, blink reflexes, respiratory, pulse rate, checking the femoral artery, and then also just the heart rate. Then also, if it was hooked up to fluids, you would note down the fluids. We don't generally do DII, SYS, or NAP monitoring. We do have a little machine that does do that for us. That's what we check for the patients who's under anesthesia. Also making sure that they're not too light under the anesthesia to wake up. So that's why we generally keep our isoflurane at 2, unless it seems the patient's going far too deep. That's my monitoring the patient under anesthesia by myself without the assistance of the machine. And then I would write down all of that information onto its anesthesia monitoring sheet, as you saw me doing in the other video. Thank you.